One, two, checking volume.
Cameras here. They're from Home Box Office.
Don't mind the cameras. We hired them to make ourselves look more
important. Whoa, big HBO.
Us with, you know, country rock movement or whatever, and I don't think there's really anything you can do to avoid that. I listened to punk rock and blues and a lot of things before we ever heard country music, so it's definitely as much a part of us or more than what a lot of people have perceived us to be. A lot of people at our shows are like us. I don't really go to shows and go crazy and jump around and like go, wow, all right, woo. You know, like we have nights where we're
type
loose.
Or another.
Yeah. I don't think we ever, there's been times where we completely fall apart, that's for sure.
Or fallen down.
But some of those times, those shows sometimes happen to be the most enjoyable, from audience perspective also, it seems to be. Like, people really enjoy watching a band fall apart for some reason, you know.
You try to give the people
Yeah. watching you and see it all too clear. I only taste the saline, I kiss away your tears. Really had me going, wishing on a star. But the black holes that surround you are heavier by far. I believed in your confusion, you're so completely torn. It must have been that yesterday, the day that I was born. Not much to examine, nothing left to hide. Really can't be serious.
rock. Well, you know, I was just trying to play a bass with a slide, and it's much, much easier with only one string. After a couple of years, added a second string. We came up with this format, and we thought, well, let's give it a try. And the joke's on us, because here we are, still doing it.
Said I like to see a little more fat. Yeah, I like to see a little more fat.
Nudity in music, yeah.
Now, I was lobbying to have my naked breasts on the record.
That's true. She wanted to paint her breasts.
Which I thought would have thematically
also been good, yeah.
With Double Colossus, D. But
that'd be another good name for the record,
Double D.
D. We recorded the record in Brooklyn. We decided that we would just go into my friend's house. It was garage with some recording equipment and just bang out a new record just fast. We mixed the record in Wisconsin. We ended up going to Madison because Doug Olson, the guy who produced the record, works out of Smart Studios. Hey, now you're gonna get me started about drummers. They're really, basically, they're just freaks, drummers. There's something wrong with them. Kids, make the rock feel good. If it feels good, do it. My grandfather used to tell me that.
Generation. guns and ethyl alcohol.
Y'all say your names on what instrument you play?
Hi, I'm Bob, and I play the didgeridoo.
My name is Lou, and
I write amazing pop songs.
My name's Jason, and I play drums, bass, guitar, and I can record things.
Would you guys ever sell out and be on a major label?
Well, I mean, we've talked to a lot of different people, and we just feel that it's best to just kind of do what we've been doing for a while and just kind of keep on doing it.
Okay. What do you think about major labels?
I don't know. I mean, if you really
make a lot of money.
You can make a lot of money, but
I want to make.
Well, it's a certain. But you don't want to give up creative.
Never control. Let me talk.
Sorry. Okay. Do you guys have a vegan recipe for my fanzine?
Jason? No.
Tend to like me.
You eat ham sometimes.
I like a hamsicle now and then.
Assassination. Shucksination. With such a brutal crime. Who's killing Christmas time? They kept a hero under mistletoe.
About that when you're dealing with them.
That's true.
I said, hello, Satan. I believe it's time to go.
Okay, my sister Holly and I were in a taxi, and the guy's name was a certain expletive beginning with F, right? And it ends in K. There was no C involved, right?
I'm gonna beat my woman till I get satisfied.
His last name was M-A-N. So if you use your imagination, instead it read on the license plate, the guy's name was F asterisk asterisk.
This is HBO, man. You're not censored on HBO.
You're not?
No, you're
not. Oh, fuck man. What a great cab driver.
Thank you. We have to explain the rules of the deli tray game now. Anything that we throw out from this lovely deli tray, provided for us by Irving Plaza, can be thrown back at us. If it didn't come off that fucking deli tray, it can't come back at us, okay?
Nope, no bricks, no tire irons, no bottles of beer.
Feel free to make a sandwich out of that. Oh.
Oh. It takes just takes one person to spoil everybody's fun. Now we're gonna have to run down to the deli and get more food. Headphones and every star that shines in the back of my mind is just waiting for its cover to be. Democrats can't give you the facts. Parents won't tell you till you've grown. And every star that shines in the back of your mind is just waiting for its cover to be. Badges, just like the law of averages. Nobody likes them where they're from. But every star that hides on the back of the bus is just waiting for his cover. Hey, I don't think we had any Hall's throat lozenges on our deli tray.
to throw the deli tray at him and try and unify him in some sort of hatred or love, you know?
Some generally stupid gesture.
Yeah, as in a New York audience, we throw the deli tray out and bricks come back.
Really? Tried it in Philly and didn't like
throw the deli
saw
tray
very much.
Steak and cheese sandwiches came back. Yeah.
We threw out 2 loaves of bread, 3 fish. 40 fish come back.
Where was that again?
Gaza?